Hello everyone, SuperCraft here, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Galaxy on the Super Mario 3D All-Stars. I was trying to get the pole star during the backflip there, didn't quite work out, but who cares, it's fine, we're gonna do a speedy combo in Dreadnought Galaxy. Because I think with these last couple stars before unlocking Bowser, we're gonna want to get some comets out of the way, that way, because as I recall, I believe they're a bit annoying to do. Kind of on their own at the end of the game, so let's try to focus more so on comets this episode. That way they aren't hogging all of our time after we've beaten Bowser. Anyway, so this is just a speedrun. Honestly, we probably speedrun it the first time anyway, but you know, can always be faster. Come on, green guy. I need green guy, not green guts, green guy. Very different. This is Mario, which is a major multimedia. Is Mario multimedia? And there's games, very prominently. Not really movies and TV shows, at least currently. I know they had probably a bunch of weird stuff in the like 80s or 90s, but like as it stands right now, Mario is very dominant in games, but I think he's mostly just games. Thank you, in return, let me create a shortcut for you. Okay, I'm going to transform! Alrighty. Much thanks, Luma. And now we just get ourselves a whole load of star chips here. Pole star chips. Very important distinction there. Where is that? There we go. Right here. Thank you. I'll be on my way then. Ah, this part's next. Very fun. And yeah, let's get the life stream. I know we'll probably be fine either way, but kind of, I just want to get it. Okay, we do want to be fast here, but not reckless. I call this measured aggression. Give me those star bits. I almost called them star chips. Those are different. Okay. Here we go. As we, go across here, I think it would be fun for us all to play a nice little game with each other right now. Here is the game. You guys, right now, leave in the comments what time are we going to end up finishing this level with. And we'll see who is the most accurate. And obviously, please don't cheat by just, you know, watching to the point in the video where we beat the game and see what the time's gonna be. And by beat the game, I mean beat the level. Anyways. So do that now. You can pause and like. I mean, we're already at the boss fight, so it's probably not going to be too much different from right now. But we can maybe do that at the next dare. This is the Daredevil comments. At the next speedrun comments. There we go. Simple. Not a problem. Let's use the long jump. I do love me a good long jump in this game. Yeah! Spin! Okay, thank you. I spin you right around, Top Man, right round, like a spinning top, or right round, yeah, round. Ah, oh, I thought I had him on that one. There we go. He can be tough to catch. Boom! 2 minutes and 40 seconds left on the clock. Which meant that start took like probably 3 minutes and 60 seconds. Nice. Anyway, so, but this episode's most likely going to just go until we get to 60 stars. Regardless of how long it takes. Anything interesting to do here? We can do the third star in Deep Dark Galaxy. Been kind of piecemealing this one a bit, so yeah, let's do it. Oh yeah, we already did Dare to Run there. Guppy and the Underground Lake. Guppy's an interesting character, because he's recurring, but he only appeared in like the second to last dome. Which is interesting to have a recurring character in the game appear that late. But you know, that's cool. He's fine and interesting enough. I mean, like, he's not like a hugely main character in the game or anything, so it's fine. I mean, you're not gonna see him any like 3DS Mario Kart games or anything, but you know, he's here. He's cool. He's staking claim to the waters, which is good for him, I suppose. I mean, given the current environment of house land real estate prices being as high as they are in much of the country, and as I understand it, it's a bit of a maybe not a worldwide thing, but certainly an international thing of multiple nations have such a thing. Stake claim to the seas. Smart. I would say. Very smart. What? You again? You gotta be kidding me. You wanted to run me out of this lake? You gotta get through all 8 rings. I hope my accents aren't slipping too much, but let's be honest, they probably are. Granted, I don't think they were very good to begin with, most likely, so slipping too much might actually be a good thing. We're gonna need some air at some point. A shell would be nice too, so it's a good thing we have one. Okay, that'll give us some air, thanks. And by air, I just mean the ability to breathe, not a momentary rise in elevation. Oh, I'm gonna miss 4. I didn't miss 4. Sweet. Okay. And where is this last one? Ah, there you are. Gotta go through. Okay, I was hoping to get a speed boost there, but we did it regardless. Very nice. Now, where is the star, physically? Alright, I'm fishing my word, take this. Okay, just get rid of the shell. And I'm gonna be taking this. As is my birthright. And by birthright, I mean competition winning rights. That was another pretty quick star, I believe. Jeez. I mean, no matter what, I'm ending this on star after we get star 60, so... Now, hopefully the episode isn't cut too short. So what have we got else here? We could do the Daredevil from Melty Molten. Not today, though. Not today. Another time, perhaps. Let's see, how about... Let's long jump this way and see what we get. Looks like we're near the fountain, let's do something there. Alright. Another Daredevil comet. I think this one will do. This one's against the top maniac, I believe. I don't know why, but I really like the comet's like warning sound. Although, I will say, back in the day as a child that wasn't nearly as good at the game, I hated comets. Because if there's a comet on the level, you can't do the normal levels. And sometimes I just kind of wanted to do the normal levels, and then there was a comet there, and I couldn't actually beat the level because I was... And by level, I mean the comet, because I was, like, awful at the game. And yeah, it was a whole thing. Obviously, I don't have such issues now, but, you know. It's all good. Man, I really need to be better at... The weird thing there is I feel like I was, like, standing still for, like, a second before I actually got killed there. Anyways. Now we're gonna do this. Alright, see? There we go. No problem. I didn't quite make it in. You know, one interesting thing I will say is that... just kind of a quirk of this boss fight is that... So he reappears later in the game, presumably, you know, harder. And the way they make him harder is by making there be less, like, electric things that can kill you on the edge. Which, granted, I guess makes sense because that's how they kill... That's how you kill him, but still. Kind of funny. Yeah. Alright. Bedrock Galaxy, hooray. Saving the game. Now we just gotta get one more to, have ourselves access to Bowser. Ain't that something? Where to do this one at? I don't know. Could do something. How about the bedroom? I don't think we've done too much in the bedroom. Let's do something fun there. Yes, the library. Thank you. What do you want, little red dude? Yes, we're going to the bedroom. I have no idea what stuff we're actually gonna do here, but... there's this question mark. Honey Climb? Let's actually do Freeze Flame Galaxy. There's a hidden star in Freeze Flame Galaxy. So the star we're gonna find the hidden star in is the Frozen Peak of Baron Burr, but we are most certainly not going to the Frozen Peak of Baron Burr. We're going all the way to the summit. Right there. But first, we gotta talk to this and catch this whole penguin dude. Hey, old man, you practicing how to skate too? Well, why don't we play a game? Can you catch me? Almost certainly. Okay, you go that way, I'll go this way. Oi? I'm going to the underside of the platform? That's Jaden, mates! No matter. Got him anyway. Not bad, old man. With skating skills like that, you might have a chance. A small chance, maybe, but a chance. Now, one thing I will say about Super Mario Galaxy is it is kind of... the worlds are kind of weird. Which, granted, I guess is the whole, like, point. It's kind of this, like, weird fantasy version of space. But, like, these planets, let's be honest, they're... well, they're all way too small to have... the gravitational fields that they are, you know, making, but the strength that they've got. But also, they are, like, the populations on these planets, which presumably... well, I was gonna say presumably must be, like, entirely isolated since they're on different planets, but I guess the existence of, like, launch stars and stuff kind of counteracts that point. Rats. I think you've really got to nail the ice flower. Triple jump there. Now we're gonna die from hypothermia. That ain't fun. I'm sure my body was entirely ice just moments ago, but, you know, swimming in mildly chilly water, that's gonna do it for you. Game over, man. There we go. Now we are en route to the summit. And we get to enjoy the fire flower. How cool. Oh, and these bats! Bats are always the worst in video games. Has anyone else chronicled this fact? Because if not, it needs to be noted down by someone. Stay away from... Oh, I needed to have the fire flower here. Okay. Here we go again. Sorry for taking such a lead. Just really stroll. Clearly, I should have acted with more haste. How long do these footprints last? And obviously, they don't last forever, but they seem to last a decent amount of time. Ah, there we go. This will do it. Thank you, Sling Star. Bit more fire in my life. Yeah. In the immortal words of the current U.S. president, you're fired. Drat. Just trying to take a shortcut, man. I'll just be clear, that wasn't a political joke. That was in reference to The Apprentice. Which is actually something I haven't ever actually watched, but I know about it. Just by reputation. And let's be honest. And by let's, I mean, I'll be honest. That's by reputation is probably how I know about, like, a solid, like, 70% of pop culture that I would describe myself as familiar with. Most of the time it's by reference. Just by, not reference, but by, I'm drawing a blank here, but despite the fact that I think I literally just said the word. By reputation. Okay, there we go. And that, speaking of reputation, that is a star. All the way from the top of the summit. Here we are back at the lobby, for lack of a better word. Something cool is about to happen, I think. And our high score's been updated. New galaxy discovered. You can hear or see it there, but a nice smile. The Comet Observatory has full power. Now it can fly through the cosmos again. Yes, it can. Yes, it can, Rosalina. It's time. Do you want to go to the location of your special one at the center of the universe?
I'm ready to press this go button. But you all are going to be pressing this wait button, because this is the end of this episode of Let's Play Super Mario Galaxy on Super Mario 3D All-Stars. Next episode, we're going to the center of the universe. I look forward to seeing you all there. Till then, though, I've been Sumercraft, and I will catch you in the next episode. Goodbye.